What's up, YouTube? V8's back with another review. Up for review, we have the second offering from Sideshow Collectibles in their DC Trinity line, namely the Superman Premium Format comic version. First up, let's look at the box. The box is pretty straightforward. There's no graphics on it, it just has the Superman logo, and it wraps around the box as you can see in the pictures. Before we look at the assembly, I want to mention that as a welcome addition, Sideshow has included an instruction sheet to guide you in the assembly process like they used to do earlier with some of the earlier premium formats. Assembly of the statue is pretty straightforward. First you insert the body into the base, next you attach the head, and then finally you attach the cape. Now the cape is a tricky part, and that's why I figure Sideshow included the instructions. The best way is you loosen the suit around the head, and then you guide the cape slowly into place. This is a statue I've been waiting for almost all this year, and honestly I was not disappointed when I received it in hand. Superman is arguably one of the most recognized superheroes in pop culture. I think the only other comic book hero that comes remotely close is Batman, at least from the DC lineup. The statue is depicting a scene from the Fortress of Solitude. It's a premium format, so it's mixed media, quarter scale. As I said earlier, this is the second statue from the DC lineup of characters that Sideshow is putting out. The first was Batman in what they call the DC Trinity. The good thing is I see that the statue doesn't have any of the pitfalls that the earlier version had, namely the saggy suit around the armpits. The suit clings well to the body, and honestly really works well with the physique that we expect of Superman. The base is pretty simplistic, but it works well with the overall theme of the statue. The paint apps are good, there's no negatives that I could see there, and the body sculpt is amazing. Nitpicks that I have with the statue, there are a few. One is, personally I feel it suffers from the same problem that Batman has, and maybe it's because of the sculpted cape. I feel that the statue isn't as stable as I would want it to be, in the sense that I feel if nudged in the right direction it would fall over. Another nitpick that I noticed was the arms, and namely the fists, are attached via a seam. Now I don't know if it was meant to have magnets, but for some reason when I took the statue out of the box I noticed that there was a seam. Yes, you don't see it because the suit covers it up, but I know it's still there. The sculpt cape is a double-edged sword in my opinion. Yes, it looks great. It takes you away from the problems that fabric and other types of capes have. But it also is the Achilles heel for this statue, I feel. Again, I feel that because of the weight of the cape, it helps to maybe imbalance the statue if given the push in the right direction. Another negative I heard, and I haven't personally tried because I got the regular version, the exclusive version that has a switch-out head. Basically, you would need to remove the cape, put on the replacement head, and then put the cape back on. And because it's such a hassle, I personally know some people that have just chose one head and stuck with it in the fear of scratching up the headscarf from by the cape. So would I recommend the statue? Definitely yes. If you're a Superman fan, a DC fan, or just a comic book fan, this is a statue that you should definitely look into. The good thing is Sideshow made a ton of these. They're still available at decent prices. There's no reason really not to get them. And the fact that we have very few quarter scale Superman statues. So yes, I would definitely recommend that you look into acquiring this piece. Finally, I would like to thank you for watching. I would like to request if you liked what you saw, to like, comment, and subscribe. And till I see you next time, this is VA tuning out.